What's going on, guys? Back again with a much requested video, the difference between loose rein and contact, the pros and the cons, why not. Whenever I think about the two most trained horses in the whole horse industry, the two sports that come to mind, we're talking about sports that the only thing that they're doing is training the horse. They're asking for nothing more of them except show me how trained your horse is. The two sports that come to mind is reining and dressage. Dressage being a lot older, 400 or 500 years old, and reining being a good bit newer, you know, 50, 60, 70 years old. And what I noticed, the big difference that I see, to me, it's the exact same sport. It's just we're wearing different clothes and we're looking for a little bit different stuff, but it's the same sport. Show me how broke your horse is. Show me what control you have of them. How little can the cues be? How much can your horse do for you? The big difference that I see is in dressage, for a horse to be finished, it takes years and years for them to finish. And for a reining, at 3 years old, they have futurity horses that are finished, have flying lead changes, spin, slide, do all the difference. Do I think it's because American Quarter Horses are just so much smarter than Warm Bloods and Andalusians? Absolutely not. Do I think the reiners are just that much better horsemen than the dressage riders? No, I think we're all in the same boat. The big difference that I see, and I can say this because I come from gated horses, which ride very English, very dressage style on a contact rein, is that whenever I'm being on a gated horse or a dressage horse or an English horse, my communication is this: bad horse, good horse, bad horse, good horse, bad horse, good horse. Everything happens right here inside my hands because we're on a contact rein. We're on a rein that he's feeling the whole time. So the margin of error is very small and the reward for doing right is very small. Versus whenever I ride him around Western, like a reiner, when he's doing the right thing, here you go, here's all the reins. Good boy, bad boy. Good boy, bad boy. Very quickly, it becomes so apparent so early, so quickly, that on that loose rein, oh, I'm doing the right thing. So the pros to being on a loose rein is the horse is gonna understand very clearly, very quickly, how to do the right thing, what's right, what's wrong, what the repercussion is. The other thing is whenever they're on a loose rein, you feel like they're not surging on you. You feel like you can do everything, slow them down, back them up, do everything, get them doing what you want without having to touch their face. So it lends well for a lot of things. Being handy, being able to go bridleless. There's a lot more reining horses that are bridleless horses than dressage horses, because the dressage horse and the gated horse and the English horse, they're all depending upon that contact. With that being said, all my national championships and all the my upbringing was with contact on the rein. With that being said, now I start horses completely different than when I was a kid. When I was a kid, from the very beginning, my father would work the horse on the line, very dressage style, and I would sit up here and basically be the passenger as he was working the horse, and I would have the contact rein and go ahead and get that horse comfortable to driving. Now, we colt start a horse, then we do reining with a horse for 2, 3, 4 weeks while we're getting control of their body, walk, trot, canter on a loose rein. Yes, the Pasapinos walk, trot, canter on a loose rein, and we really get them relaxed and control of their body. And then once we have that, we start putting them back together, gathering up that rein. By that point, they know how to give the pressure. They know what we're asking. They know about the body part control, and we're able to put them back on a contact rein. Also, I use a contact rein for neck reining, and that would look like this. Whenever I want to start collecting my horse and I want to put my Western horse on a contact rein, I'll start doing this. I'll start drawing right down to his withers and driving him forward with my legs, like so. And what this is gonna do is it's really gonna help get my horse collected, get his butt and get his face closer together, get his legs under him. See if we trot him off here. Good boy. Release, one hand stays on his withers. That's gonna allow me to keep that pressure down low because I don't wanna pick up his head. And release him. So I want him to be able to accept that contact, but then I'm gonna let him go for being a good boy there. So that's how I would use that contact rein on a Western horse. On my English horses or my gated horses, I'm gonna drive that horse here into a frame, and that's how I'm gonna go compete. The difference and the pro for the contact rein is I can communicate so quietly. whenever you are showing, I have spider webs in my hair, whenever I'm showing on a loose rein, you have to have all that communication through your legs and being subtle with your spurs and your legs and your feet, because you can't communicate with the lines. Whenever I am communicating with my gated horses in the show ring, everything happens right here inside my hands. So I can tell them to pick a shoulder up or to not look outwards or to do anything, speed up, slow down, good boy, bad boy. All those things happen on that contact rein right here. So I'll be going around the ring for an hour in the show ring, and all my conversation happens right inside this frame, and that's my contact rein. So the pros of the contact rein is that we can have real subtle communication in our hands. The pros of that long rein, that western rein, is we really get a horse where they don't try to build, and they get a lot more handy because they're guiding off of your legs and off of your seat versus on your hands. So this is gonna give you a lot more relaxed look. So I'm using this loose rein for anything western, anything that I want handy, obstacles, trail riding, anything like that. And then I'm using my contact rein for any horse that I wanna build up. If I'm trying to make a dressage horse, if I'm trying to make a gated horse, I wanna drive that horse up into the bridle, make them big, make them bold, and I'm gonna have them right there in my hands. So those are the pros and cons of contact versus loose. Hope that helps you. Hope that answers some of the questions that you guys have had, and I'll see you in the next video.